If you want to make a copy of an existing file, you can do so by using the option Copy Return that's available on this menu here. So you can use this, for example, to create a scenario of the file. It will keep all of the existing data and let you work on a different alternative in this case. So I will use a label to distinguish that return, and you will see that it will immediately open that file for you. So now you're seeing that for Julian, you have the scenario B file open, and your original one is still available a click away from here. If you go back to the text menu, you're able to see now that you have the original file here, and then the new one right here with scenario B. So you'll be able to sort by name as well to be able to see them next to each other like this. So in addition to copying, you're able to rename. So let's say that label scenario B is not the one you wanted. You want to call this, no, it's scenario C, for example. Just change the label here and it will be reflected in the grid the next time that you refresh your grid. You can refresh the grid by pressing F5 to query and list all the returns that are available in iframe text for you. So we can now see the new name. So from this menu, you're also able to delete. So you have to be extra careful here because this is a complete deletion. There's no restore possible. So make sure that when you delete, it's only for returns that you don't need to file or that you have not already filed.
If you have any questions or concerns about this or any other features in CCH iFirm Tax, please contact the Wolters Kluwer Support Center at 1-800-268-4522 or see support at WoltersKluwer.com.